You've heard of body butter, but what the heck is a body yogurt? Think of it as body butter's ultra-light cousin, a fast-absorbing and super-slippy body moisturizer, low on rich oils and high in hydrating humectants. It is perfect for the coming summer months if you want all the moisturizing power of a body butter but none of the heaviness or greasiness. In this video, I'm going to whip up this sumptuously silky, Body Shop-inspired strawberry body yogurt with oodles of wobbly goodness that vanishes on the skin faster than a Canadian summer. Plus, this simple formulation is super customizable, so prepare to get creative. Before we can get into the formulation, a word of warning. The end result can be sticky if you're not careful. Fear not though, because later in the video, I'll be sharing a sneaky industry trick to keep your body yogurt beautifully lightweight and non-tacky. Stay tuned. Let's get to the making, shall we? We're going to whip up a 300 gram batch today, and we'll start with the heated water phase. Our first ingredient is the cheap, hydrating one that makes up the bulk of the formulation, 179.39 grams distilled water. Up next, our first humectant. I've chosen this one because it's effective and low tack. Weigh out 15 grams of Propanediol 1-3. To amp up the skin hydrating and luxury factors, you'll also need 60 grams of a 1% hyaluronic acid solution. This is a solution you'll need to make yourself from hyaluronic acid powder. Check out the Humblebee and Me blog post linked in the description for instructions on how to do just that. I've used equal parts high molecular weight and low molecular weight hyaluronic acid solutions, but you can definitely use just one or the other. This next ingredient is our awesome gelling agent, which gives this product its wobbly thickness and slippy skin feel. 4.5 grams of Polyacrylate Cross Polymer 6, also known as Sepamax Zen. I've found this to be the magical concentration to ensure a soft, blendable product that rivals the Body Shop's. And I'll be sharing another sneaky tip for silky, non-sticky formulation goodness shortly. There are a few substitutions that can work in place of Sepamax Zen, so make sure you check out the free partner blog post for those. Up next is a fun part, adding a pop of pink to your product. Or really, this can be any color that strikes your fancy. I really like to match it to the fragrance and possibly the carrier oil as well to create a theme. So wrapping up our heated water phase is 0.015 grams of water-soluble red dye. Now, this amount is so tiny that you probably won't be able to weigh it out, so if you are using Red 40 like I am, a single grain is about right. Don't worry if this looks super, super red. It will soften into a really lovely pink once we get emulsifying. Now for our heated oil phase. We'll begin with our emulsifier. I've chosen one with an ultra-light skin feel that plays really nicely with the ingredient that makes this body yogurt all wobbly. Weigh out 4.5 grams of Glyceryl Stearate and PEG 100 Stearate. Please be wary if changing up the emulsifier. Believe me, I learned this one the hard way. Just feast your eyes on this appetizing, goopy body cheese. Ugh. I've seen this called the cheesecake effect, and it can happen if your emulsifier contains fatty alcohols, like the stearyl alcohol in this emulsifying wax NF version. Up next is our star emollient. I've chosen 27 grams of lovely strawberry seed oil, but this can easily be switched for another more inexpensive oil. I would recommend grapeseed oil for a similar effect, but go with what speaks to you. Other fun, fruity options include raspberry seed oil, apricot kernel oil, and blueberry seed oil. Yum. Combine the ingredients for the heated water phase and the heated oil phase in two separate beakers. If you've been watching my videos for a while, you'll know I often include gelling ingredients like Sepamax N in the heated oil phase to prevent clumping. With this formulation, however, I have found that there is so much gelling ingredient that clumping is actually less likely if you include it in the water phase, as that gives it more time to hydrate and activate. Before moving on, weigh the heated water phase, noting the weight of the entire lot. And yes, that includes the beaker. And so this way, we can easily replace any water that is lost to evaporation during heating. For heating, you've got two options. I'll be using my lab hot plate on low, which is about 70 degrees Celsius, and simply placing both beakers directly on it. If you don't have a hot plate, you can use a water bath instead. So just place both heated phases in a wide, shallow pan with about 3 centimeters of water in it and heat over low to medium low heat for about 20 to 30 minutes. As everything starts to heat through, I wanted to take a minute to share some super exciting stuff we're doing over on Patreon. So for those of you who don't know, we select a new product every month to do a live breakdown of the ingredient list and formulation on a patron exclusive live stream. I guide my patrons through each and every step, from researching the ingredients to creating a starter dupe formulation. In fact, you can check out the replay and spreadsheets for the Body Shop's body yogurt analysis that's available right now on Patreon to exclusive videos and up patrons. You'll learn what it truly takes to formulate and break down ingredient lists. So if that sounds up your alley, please consider becoming a patron by clicking the link in the description box below. Now, back to our yogurt. Halfway-ish through the heating, stir the water phase to ensure the Sepamax Zen is hydrating and incorporating well. It'll look like thick raspberry jelly at this point. Once the emulsifier has melted and both phases are roughly the same temperature, we are ready to proceed. Remove the beakers from the heat, weigh the water phase, and top it back up to its preheat weight, which you noted down earlier, with a bit of distilled water. And now for the fun part. Pour our water phase, our raspberry jelly phase, into the heated oil phase, stir the mixture, and then grab your immersion blender and blend for about 2 minutes. This is longer than I would usually blend a lotion, but because it's already so thick, thanks to all the Sepamax Zen, you need to blend it for quite a long time just to give it time to fully turn over and blend in any lumps of the Sepamax Zen. Be patient, don't pump the blender up and down, just watch as that mixture slowly turns itself over and becomes smooth and uniform. Make sure you scrape down the blender head every so often, as this really does get very thick very quickly, and we want to make sure there's no little lumpy bits of Sepamax Zen left being lumpy. Once the mixture is uniform, leave it to finish cooling. Once the body yogurt has cooled to roughly room temperature, it's time for the final step, the cool down phase. Make sure you're using an accurate scale for this, preferably accurate to 0.01 grams. This is where we incorporate our preservative, 1.5 grams of liquid Germall Plus, along with 1.5 grams of vitamin E to extend the shelf life of the strawberry oil. Remember when I said I had a top secret industry technique to avoid stickiness? That is where 6 grams of dimethicone 350 comes in, the key to a luxurious formula that doesn't feel sticky on your skin. You could also use cyclomethicone instead for an even lighter final product. It's worth noting that while they're not natural, silicones do readily degrade and have been continuously found to not only be very safe, but also beneficial to the skin by experts around the world. A natural silicone alternative like LuxGlide 350 is a decent substitution here, but I don't find the natural options to be quite as effective at de-tackifying. For a gorgeous, juicy scent, weigh out 0.6 grams of a strawberry-y, berry-y fragrance oil, but of course this can be just as easily switched out for another scent, because it's your creation after all. Incorporate all 4 cool-down ingredients into the master batch, and voila! All that's left is to package it up into a wide mouth jar. I chose a clear container so you can see the body yogurt in all of its luscious pink glory. There you have it, a beautiful, lightweight emulsion that is your hydrating, must-have companion this summer. A little goes a long way, so this is sure to last you a while. My advice? Pop this on damp skin post-shower to lock in moisture. It'll absorb in seconds and leave you smelling of summery strawberries. Now, if you're prone to super dry hands and want something with more moisturizing oomph, you will love this video on how to recreate the Body Shop's best-selling hemp hand protector. One is sold every 12 seconds, so it's gotta be good.